This is a good eating apple.
Oh, good.
And then we'll get those other ones for that apple cake.
Oh, perfect.
Oh, we need to light a fire.
Oh, look at that beauty.
Yeah, that's gorgeous.
Oh, this is almost fermented. They're so beautifully preserved. I'm ready for fall, aren't you?
Oh, anyway, I'm in the mood for those more complex flavors.
Yeah, really. It kind of has this depth and this sweetness somewhere underneath it. So it's very layered and very satisfying right now.
Okay. This year, we're going to do a whole year of Italian cooking. It's kind of exciting.
That looks so Italian.
The color looks so good. Look at that pumpkin. Oh, there are all the butchers.
They look good.
There's Harry's Bar in Venice.
Oh, and there's our apple cake.
Actually, we've learned so much about getting flavor into food from the Italians.
Yeah.
Why don't we do that apple cake?
The torta? Yes.
I mean, that is good.
Oh, that's nice. This is a dolcetto.
In Piedmont, where all the famous truffles come from.
Cheers.
I mean, whether it's reducing the wine or cooking the tomato paste, they know how to pair
to
that
sweet
deep,
and salty
deep
and,
sweet
yeah.
with that deep, salty, porky flavor.
You know, that's one of the great things about this fall dish. It has the chestnuts.
The pancetta.
The pancetta and the cinnamon, that warm flavor. Now, these chestnuts.
When they cook. In this red wine, they get soft and they break apart a little bit and they thicken the sauce.
Oh, the souple.
And now we'll just make them into little balls and put a piece of mozzarella on the inside. Italian food in Italy is really nothing like Italian food in America. It's, in a way, plain.
Woo!
In a wonderful way.
It's all about the ingredient. And then this cooking that just sort of supports and showcases that ingredient.
Look at what we're bringing. Oh,
that is gorgeous.
Are you doing this for the La Dolce Vita cookbook? Is this going to be, it's in the La Dolce Vita?
Now it's gone.